Hello, I'm Artifacts Mars, and this is Disclosure, coming to you from the Finger Lakes region of sunny western New York State, in Science Valley, south of Rochester. And what you're about to see is real. You can make your own judgments on exactly what it is that you're seeing. Thank you for watching, and let's get started with the video. Today we're going to look at more of these lines. This is really dramatic stuff. I will post the coordinates on this. There's multiple areas of these lines, and I got something pretty amazing. This one may well run into two parts, or three, even. I doubt it, but I doubt it'll run into three parts. But here we go. There's multiple instances of these lines. And what I'm... As usual, they follow the contour. They follow the contour that... little hill here. Whatever it is. I'm not so sure these ones do follow the contours so well. It's not looking like they do. In many places, the lines do follow the contour, though. And I don't know what to make of this. However, I do have some dramatic information on it. I believe it to be part of some kind of underground infrastructure. I'm going to show you the reason why in a still photo of this. See how this is nice and regular? This is not a photographic anomaly. Okay, this is Artifacts again. I had an incoming phone call. Sorry for the distraction. There may be another one. Notice how nice and regular this is? This is not a photographic anomaly. A photographic anomaly wouldn't be changing pitch or anything. I have reason to believe, a very strong reason to believe, that we're seeing some sort of underground structure. The only contraindication of that is that it seems to go over this area. I can't even tell if this area here is raised or not. One thing we're not looking at is anything that's fake. It's not a photographic anomaly or anything like that. The conclusion I've reached is that this is, like I said, an underground infrastructure of some kind. It seems to be somewhat common in the Mars photos. Somebody built all of this, folks. Perhaps a long time ago. And the reason I say a long time ago, I will get to in due course. You see, as I'm dragging this, you can see how far this extends. We're talking dozens or hundreds of miles. I'm not going to try to figure out exactly how far. Here's a curious thing, though. These lines extend across craters, and I don't have an answer for that. I wish I had an explanation for that, but I don't. Well, there is a possibility is that the infrastructure was built after. I mean after the craters happened. You see what I'm getting at? Impact craters happened a long time ago, and then somebody was building underneath. A long time later. Other than that, I don't know what to make of it. Now, I'm going to see if I can find the area that I photographed on this. You're not going to believe this. I'm not sure I can find it again, actually, but this might actually be the area. I'm going to have to bring that photo up. You can see how we have a structured deal there. Oh, I remember what the photo is, and it's not... It's not quite like this. You just gotta see it. It's kind of a almost checkerboard thing. Well, here we go. We have infrastructure underneath. Yeah, I'm gonna bring that photo up in a minute. These streets, they go for a long distance, and talking dozens and dozens of miles, because the altitude is really high. So this isn't anything small. It's not done by nature. Nature isn't dragging something across the ground doing this. This is something that's a part of the ground, and it's artificial, and it's apparently been built underground. Why don't I go ahead and put this on hold, and we'll bring up that one photo. Hang on. Okay. As I've said, here we have a still photo. It's the only photo I've taken from this. Now, this is unedited. Google Earth has a feature that allows you to take a photo. If you have Google Earth, you may already know this. I'm just pointing it out. Let's take a look at this when I tweak the exposure. I'm going to take the brightness down. I'm going to take the contrast up. And ever seen anything so regular as this? This is an underground infrastructure. I'm not sure how much of it is underground and how much isn't. But this is taken from the area that I'm in. If this don't clue you in, nothing will. This could not have been done by nature. It's done by a race of beings that are on that planet. I think that should be obvious. It's not done by nature. It's done artificially. If you can't see it, then you are blind. Get your eyes checked. Other than that, I can't tell whether this is piping or buildings or what it is. But the idea anybody would think that this is not artificial, I just cringe. I don't know how you say that this is anything but artificial. I'm not talking about soil on top, I'm talking about what's causing this effect. This is pretty dramatic right here. If you can't see it, I'm sorry. But, you know, there you have it. If that don't convince you, nothing will. Anyway, So you really need to get on our government and tell us the truth about this. There's no way in hell that I could explain this as anything but some kind of artificial construction. Whether it be a piping system, which I'm beginning to doubt, or some kind of underground infrastructure. I think underground infrastructure is probably closer to the truth. Take a look at areas like this. That don't tell you something, nothing will. You see, if these were tracks being made by vehicles, how is it built? Vehicles aren't falling down in. This is my point. I think we'll take a still and take a quick look on this before I go. Hang on. Okay, this is a still that I took. And I tweaked the lighting so that you can see just dramatic evidence that this is some kind of artificial activity. And I don't know how you explain this as anything but. Well, the question remains, what exactly we're seeing. And only thing I can think, like I said, some sort of underground infrastructure, remembering that we're talking miles and miles long. So I don't know how these could be steel girders or anything like that. Not that long. How the hell would they even smell them? You see what I'm saying? So these are apparently steel girders of some kind. Well, not steel girders, but they're some kind of infrastructure under the ground. Now I'm going to go back. I'm going to pull up Google Earth. I'm going to show you the same basic thing, same basic area. Only I've changed the angle. I'm almost flat with the ground. Is there anybody out there who still thinks that you're seeing something that isn't artificial? I just feel sorry for you. If you think this isn't artificial, I'm sorry. I can't feel anything but pity for you. Because while it may not look like cities on Earth, it's definitely buildings or something. Underground infrastructure, living quarters perhaps. That's what we're seeing. There isn't any question, folks. So what we need here is a call to... Maybe we need to bug NASA and let them know, hey, this really sucks that we're not being told the truth. I can go on and on for hours about this area, and it's just incredible. But there you have it. There's more than enough proof right there to say, hey, NASA, screw you, you're lying to us. You know there's life there. You know there's people living on that planet in all likelihood. At least there were people living on that planet. Even if they're not there now. And sorry about that. Computer went berserk. It's been giving me grief. This is an old desktop. It's going to have to be replaced here shortly. this is Artifacts Mars. I'm going to sign off, and I will keep looking for anomalies on the Martian surface. If you haven't figured it out by now, if you don't get it by now, that there are people living on that planet, or at least have been, then it's just too bad. I mean, right here we have the infrastructure, you can see it. It's obvious. It is blatantly obvious that we have infrastructure under the ground on that planet. I'm Artifacts of Mars, thanks for watching.